Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you believe Satan is paralyzed in your life, rise up and shout about it.
To ba gbagbo wipe Satan ti da aro patapata ninu aye re
bi de ko so be
o ti yaro bayi o ninu aye re ninu ebi re o ti yaro ninu ise re o yaro bayi ati segun e lori aya re ati segun re lori oko re ati segun re lori ebi re ni bayi o ti yaro patapata.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
Almighty God, we thank you.
Olorun Olodumare adupe lowo yin.
We bless your name for reminding us.
Ati ibukun fun oruko yin pe ran wa
leti. Jesus died on the cross.
Pe nigba ti Jesu ku lori agbelegun.
Satan is paralyzed.
Satan ti yaro.
Sicknesses are removed.
Aisan ti kuro.
Yokes are broken.
Ajaga ti ja.
Curses are taken away.
Ebolo ti kuro.
Victory is ours in Jesus' name.
Isegun ni ti wa ni oruko Jesu.
Lord, I pray tonight.
Oluwa mo gbadura lale yin.
Nobody will make the right choice. The choice to be on the side of the Lord. And then Satan will have no power in any life. And then sickness will not remain in any world. And then defeat will not remain in our business. Every good thing will come to us in Jesus' name. Lord, confirm it tonight.
That
Satan is paralyzed in our lives. Thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight, I want to tell you what the Lord is telling you. We are in Joshua chapter 24 and verse 15. It says, and it would seem evil unto you to serve the Lord. Choose you this day whom you will serve. I want to tell you at this important moment. The message of tonight is, make your choice today. Make your choice today. When you were born into this world, you had no choice. You couldn't choose your father. You couldn't choose your mother. You couldn't choose a family. You couldn't choose a place where you were born. You couldn't choose a country where you were born. All those things already are determined. And here you find yourself. You couldn't even choose the people that surrounded you. The circumstances around you, you had no power to choose. But then, as you have come into this life, and you understand the right from the left, you understand there is good, there is evil. You understand there is blessing, there is a curse. You understand there is heaven, there is hell. You understand there is happiness, there is sadness. And then you're asking yourself,
to
be born in the world, I didn't have a choice. Family, I didn't have a choice. Town, I didn't have a choice. And many other things, you didn't have any choice. But I have a choice whether I am happy or sad. Do I have a choice whether I am well or I am sick? Do I have a choice whether I'm victorious or defeated? Do I have a choice of a better life? The Bible says, yes, you have a choice. That although the things that are past, you didn't have a choice. From this very day, you have a choice. And for your future, you have a choice. For where you will spend eternity, you have a choice. That's why Joshua told the people, Lord is telling you through Joshua, telling you to make your choice. There are 3 points we're going to look at. Number one is our right of choice. The Lord has given us that right. The Lord has given us that key. And we can determine what kind of life we're going to live. We can determine on which side we're going to be. On the side of the Lord, on the side of the devil. We can decide whether we're going to be blessed or we're going to remain in our problem. We can decide whether we can get healed tonight or we're going to remain under the yoke, under the bondage, under sickness. Number one, therefore, our right of choice. That's what Joshua was saying. It says, if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord. Serving the Lord means happiness. Serving the Lord means joy. Serving the Lord means blessing. Serving the Lord means provision. Serving the Lord means he'll provide for all your needs. Serving the Lord means he'll give you a good wife. Serving the Lord, he'll give you a good husband. Serving the Lord, he'll give children to your family. Serving the Lord, he'll provide for your needs. Because then, you become his property. Because then, every need in your life, he begins to supply. Already, you know when in Joshua, the children of Israel were coming from the wilderness. And the Lord said, if you will serve me, I'm going to provide for you. If you will serve me, I will conquer all your enemies. They had already seen the fulfillment of that. Jericho conquered. Confederacies of kings conquered. Many enemies conquered. And now at the end of the chapter, they said, you are no more ignorant. You know the goodness of the Lord. You know the fulfillment of his promise. You know God will never fail. Now, you have not seen enough. There is a future ahead of you. Many blessings ahead of you. And you have a right of choice. Then it said, if all the evidence you have will not convince you to serve the Lord, if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve. Whether the gods of the which your father served that were on the other side of the floor. The word of God is talking to you and talking to me. Our forefathers had idols that they worship. Our forefathers, they had the images that they serve. You make your choice tonight. I've told you what the Lord can do. The Lord can turn your darkness to light. He can turn your night to day. He can turn poverty to prosperity. He can conquer all your enemies. He can kill all your sicknesses. He can break every yoke. He can destroy every curse. He can bring a blessing into your life. But then Joshua is saying, if with all the Lord has promised to do, and with all the Lord the Lord wants to do, if you still can't teach an evil thing, to serve the Lord, choose you this day, make your choice today, whom you will serve. If you want to worship idols, if you want to serve images, if you want to serve the idols of the land that are not able to deliver their people, or the gods of the Amorites, in whose land ye dwell, if it is a modern idol, traditional idol, village idol, occultism and superstition, and all the things that the magicians are doing, if that's what you want to choose, make your choice today. And then he said, as for me, and my house, we will serve the Lord. How many of you are making the choice to serve the Lord today? You want to come to the side of the Lord. Where are you? Can you raise up your hand? You say, I will serve the Lord. Like Joshua, I will serve the Lord. Like those people of olden days, I will serve the Lord. Like the Israelites, I will serve the Lord. Like the people that were blessed, I will serve the Lord. That's what Joshua said. He said, I don't know what others are going to do. I am not waiting for the decisions of other people. He said, as for me, as for me, as for me, and my house, we will serve the Lord. And I'm going to give you a chance at the end of the message tonight to put real reality into your decision. If you are saying, as for me, I will serve the Lord, Lord. My house will serve the Lord. Myself and my wife. Myself and my husband. Myself and my children. Myself and the family. We will serve the Lord. He had the right to choose. You had the right to choose. Actually, God tells us in Deuteronomy chapter 30. Deuteronomy chapter 30. In verses 19 and 20. Deuteronomy chapter 30. Verses 19 and 20. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you. That I have said before you life and death. Blessing and cursing. Therefore choose life. Therefore choose life. Bless your right. The right of choice. On the one hand, there is life. On the one hand, there is satisfactory life. Abundant life. Eternal life. Spiritual life. On one hand, there is a better kind of life. Life in Christ. Life under His protection. Life under His power. Life with divine provision. On the one hand, there is life that satisfies. On the other hand, on the other hand, there is a Satan that oppresses. On the other hand, there is destruction. On the other hand, there is a yoke. On the other hand, there is a curse. He says, on the one hand, life. On the other hand, death. But you have the right to choose. That's why it says, therefore choose life. That both thou and thy seed may live. That thou mayest love the Lord thy God. That thou mayest obey His voice. And that thou mayest cleave unto Him. For He is thy life. Once it comes into you, it's like the life of Christ. With an injection of heaven is injected into you. It's like the goodness of heaven is put into an heaven injection. It's injected into your life. And that when that life of heaven is injected into you tonight, all poisons in your system, all curse in your system, all poverty in your system, all evil things in your system, the injection of heaven or the life of heaven coming into you will paralyze, will demolish, will destroy everything. And then good things will flush into your life. And from today, you will never be the same again. And when you make a choice tonight, the devil cannot take the good thing away from you. Evil people cannot take the good thing from you. You have the right tonight to choose. If you will choose a good thing from today, things will become better for you. I said things will become better for you. Point number two. Repentance, a good choice. Repentance, a good choice. We come back to Joshua chapter 24. And in verse 16. And the people answered and said, God forbid that we shall forsake the Lord and serve other gods. The people made their choice. Just like you are going to make your choice tonight. And the choice you make tonight will determine how happy you will be. The choice you make tonight will determine whether you are going to get healed. The choice you make tonight will determine the goodness of God in your life. The choice you make tonight will determine how prosperous your family will be. The choice you make tonight will determine where you are going to spend eternity. They made their choice. They said, God forbid that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. And then in verse 19, Joshua said unto the people, ye cannot serve the Lord. Isn't that discouraging? No, he was telling them this. So he said, if you are going to serve the Lord, it's more than raising up your hand. If you are going to serve the Lord, it's more than word of mouth. If you are going to serve the Lord, it's more than going to church. If you are going to serve the Lord, It's more than God's coming to the crusade field. That's why Joshua told them. He said, no, ye cannot serve the Lord. For he is the holy God. And you know what he means there? He said, God is of purer eyes than to behold sin or iniquity. He said, for he is an holy God. He is a jealous God. He will not forgive your trespass nor your sin.
You know
what he means by that? Is that if you don't confess, if you don't forsake, if you don't run away from it, if you don't flee iniquity and trespass, forgiveness does not come automatically. That's what Joshua is saying. Just because I go to church, and then I rise up, I repeat after the priest, I have done what I shouldn't have done, I have not done what I should have done, that doesn't automatically give you forgiveness. Just because I say, we are sinned. Because all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We're not worthy to be called by your name. That doesn't automatically give you forgiveness. That's what Joshua was saying. He said, if you just confess, and you sit on the sin, and you remain in the sin, and you are swimming in the sin, and you are swallowing the sin, and you are rejoicing in the sin, and you are delighting in the sin, they said, God will not forgive because it takes repentance. It means you are going to tell the Lord, you know you have sinned. Look at verse 21. And the people said unto Joshua,
nay,
but we will serve the Lord. He said, yes, Joshua, we know we are counting the cost. He said, yes, Joshua, we know what you mean. He said, yes, Joshua, we know it will take confession and forsaking of our sin. And he said, that's exactly what we're going to do. And in verse 23, he says, now therefore, he said, I agree with you. You are making a right choice. I agree with you. You have said it with your mouth that you will serve the Lord. All right, if you are going to serve the Lord, in verse 23, now therefore, put away. What did he say they should put away? He said they should put away the strange God which are among you. And incline your heart unto the Lord God of Israel. That's the way to the blessing of God. If there is any cause on your life today, the way you will get the blessing of God is that you will repent of your sin. And it doesn't matter. Any prophet might have told you that you are going to die. I cancel that death in Jesus' name. It doesn't matter. Anybody that has seen a vision and your relative came back home, he said, my uncle, my cousin, my sister, I went to our church. In our church, when the prophet was praying for me, he told me you have an uncle, he told me you have a cousin, go and tell him that the prophecy said he's going to die. It doesn't matter what prophecy they have made. If you will repent tonight, that curse will be cancelled in your life in Jesus' name. In Jonah chapter 3, I read verse 4, and Jonah began to enter into the city a day's journey, and he cried and said, yet 40 days Nineveh shall be overthrown. That's prophecy from a prophet. Yet 40 days Nineveh shall be overthrown. In verse 6, for the word came unto the king of Nineveh, and he arose from the throne, and he laid his robe from him, and he covered him with sackcloth, and he sat in ashes. Look at verse 8. But let man and beast, they covered with sackcloth, and cry pray mightily unto God. Let them turn everyone from his evil way. And from the violence that is in their hands. The king of Nineveh. He knew how to change negative prophecy to positive prophecy. And yokes can be broken. How the evil sin the devil wanted to do in your life can be totally removed. How even the judgment of God that is hanging upon your head can be taken away. Yes, king of Nineveh. He knew how the negative prophecy from the prophet can be wiped out, eradicated from their lives.
He said,
let every man be covered with sackcloth. Let them feel sorry for their sin. Let them cry mightily unto the Lord. He said, yes, what I'm telling everyone, let them turn everyone from his evil way and from the violence that is in their hands. That's how to do it, my brother, my sister. My friend, you are there tonight. That's how to have the blessing of God in your life.
Look at
verse 10. And God saw their works, that they turned from their evil way. God will see you tonight when you give your life to Christ. God will see you tonight when you surrender yourself to the Lord. God will see you tonight when you turn away from your sin, from your trespasses, from your drunkenness, from your adultery, from your fornication, from your evil, from your idol worship, from your occultism, from the violence in your heart, from the strife and division. God will see your heart tonight. In fact, right now, the Lord is seeing you. As you say, yes, I want the Lord. Yes, I want blessing. I will not carry all my problems into the new year. Yes, I make the choice tonight. All those bad things, I will not do them again. God sees your heart already. He will forgive you. I said he will forgive you. He will change your life. He will do good in your life. Come back to Joshua now. Number one, I told you our right of choice. Number two is repentance, a good choice. Number three now is righteousness and redemption through Christ. Righteousness and redemption through Christ. Joshua chapter 24 verse 24. You will not forget this. Joshua chapter 24 verse 24. And the people said unto Joshua, the Lord our God we will serve. His voice we will obey. Righteousness coming through Christ. Actually, Joshua is the Old Testament form of the name Jesus in the New Testament. They told Joshua, they said, we will serve the Lord. As we are going to tell Jesus, we will serve the Lord. And when you make up your mind, you will come to Jesus. You will touch him. And he will touch you. You will come to Jesus. You believe in him. And he will change your life. You come to Jesus. You say, yes, I believe. He is my Savior. Then he will save you. I believe. He is my deliverer. Then he will deliver you. I believe. He is my healer. Then he will heal you. Look at a woman in the New Testament. She made a choice. A choice to come to Jesus. She made a choice. A choice to cast her burdens on Christ. She made a choice. A choice to live. She made a choice. A choice to be well and not to be sick. Mark chapter 5. What's your choice tonight? If you are making the choice, you say, I want blessing. If you are making the choice, you say, I want healing. If you are making the choice, you say, I want deliverance. If you are making the choice, I want children in my family. You say, you are making the choice. I want the Lord to provide for me. Everything you tell the Lord tonight, according to the promise of God, he will do for you. He will fill your mouth with laughter. He will fill your family with blessing. If you are sick right there now, as we pray tonight, you are going to get well. If you are blind, you will open your eyes and see. If you are lame, you will rise up and walk. If there is any deformity, the Lord will touch your life. You will never be the same again in Jesus' name. Mark chapter 5 verse 25. Mark chapter 5 verse 25. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years.
Obinrin kan ti o ni isun eje ni odun
mejila. Serious problem for a long time.
Wahala olojo gboro to buru.
He said and had suffered many things of many physicians.
O ni eni ti oju re si ti ri ohun pupo lojo awon onisegun.
All that she had.
Ti o si ti na ohun gogo ti o ni
na. Was nothing better.
Ti ko si san rara.
But rather grew worse.
Ma kaka be o
mo si waju. 12 years.
Obinrin fodun mejila.
She was sick. And she was going from bad to worse.
O si nburu si ni.
She went to the hospital of the land.
O lo si ile iwosan
ile na. She went to the herbalist of the land.
O lo sodo awon
ye
ni
waye. She went to all the healers of the land.
O lo sodo awon ni iwosan
aye. Becoming better. She was becoming worse.
Kaka kewi agbe ero o tubo nle.
And then in verse 27.
Ni ese iketa
ni ogbon. When she heard of Jesus.
Nigba to si guro Jesu.
That's a great name.
Oruko nla re o.
It's the name that gives us life.
Oruko to fun aniye.
The name that gives us salvation.
Oruko to fun anigala.
The name that gives us healing.
Oruko to fun aniwosan.
The name that gives us deliverance.
Oruko to fun anidani.
Breaks the power and the yoke of the devil from our lives.
Oruko to nba agbara Yesu genu aye wa oruko nla
ni. When you come to that name.
To ba wa sodo oruko yi.
Believe in that name.
To ba gbo oruko yi
gbo. You will never be the same again.
O le ri bakan mo na mo ni.
Everybody mention that name, shout out that name.
Gbogbo yin e pe oruko yen ki n gbo.
Shout it and let me hear you.
Epe king go.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You're making a choice tonight. You will follow the Lord.
Wa tele Oluwa.
When she heard of Jesus.
Nigba to gburo
Jesus. She came in the press behind.
O wa seyin re laarin epe
yin. His garment.
O fowo kan aso
re. What she said.
Nitori o wi pe.
If I may but touch his clothes.
Bi mo ba le fowo mi kan aso
re.
Ara mi yo da.
She made the choice.
O yan to wu.
She said Satan you will not hinder me.
O ni Satan ni o ni mi lowo.
You will not make me to die.
O ni je nku.
Satan.
Satan
ni sickness has been going from bad to worse.
I saw me to bomb
but today I'm going to get healed. I have heard of Jesus. I have seen Jesus. I believe in Jesus. If I may but touch his clothes, I shall be made whole.
Bi mo ba le fowo kan se ti aso re ara mi yoda ese kan kan
dilogun.
Logan.
That means instantaneously. That means immediately. The fountain of her blood was dried up. And she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. Tonight is your night. Tonight is your night. Your miracle has come. Your healing has come. Your deliverance has come. Your salvation has come. Yours is a choice tonight. If you choose to come to the Lord, if you choose to believe in the Lord, if you are choosing salvation in Christ, it is there tonight. Even Satan cannot take it away from you. Rise up and make your choice. 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 I choose life. I choose life. I choose eternal life. I choose abundant life. I choose a happy life. I choose a joyful life. I choose the life of Christ. I choose a supernatural life. I choose eternal life. Come to Christ tonight. Come to Christ tonight. Satan cannot take that choice away from you. Your brother, your friend cannot take the choice away from you. Your enemy cannot take the choice away from you. Demons cannot take the choice away from you. If you choose Christ tonight, you enter into life. I choose life. And Satan will not take it from you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
You know how to choose a life already?
O mo ba tin yan yi
bayi. I presented Jesus Christ to you.
Mo ti fi Jesu han.
Jesus is waiting for your choice tonight.
Jesu wa n do de to fe yan lale.
Are you going to remain with Satan?
Se wa wa pelu Satan
sibe. Are you going to remain in your sin?
Se wa wa nu ese
sibe. Are you going to remain in idol worship?
Se wa nu bo wa nu
ese sibe. Are you going to remain under your yoke?
Se wa wa labi
ajaja sibe. Are you going to remain in the occult sin?
Se wa wa nu ego.
Jesus is waiting.
Jesus
is standing there
Jesus
right now.
Like
and he's saying, if you want him, if you want him, if you want to serve the Lord, and you want him to change your life, and to turn everything around, and you're saying, yes, I want the goodness of God in my life. If you want Jesus to be your Savior, if you want all your sins to be forgiven, if you want him to wipe away all the evil that you have done since you were born, wherever you are now, wherever you are now, just signify by raising up your hand.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah. Just raise up your hand. You want Christ? Just raise up your hand. You want life? Just raise up your hand. You want forgiveness? Just raise up your hand. You want the yoke to be broken? Just raise up your hand. You want to have eternal life? Just raise up your hand. You want Jesus to be your Lord, your Redeemer, your Savior? Just raise up your hand. Keep up that hand. Keep up that hand. As you raise up your hand, simply tell the Lord, Jesus, I come to you. Say it out. Jesus, I come to you. I come out of my sin. Every evil sin that I've done, I am sorry. I will not do them again. I turn away from my sin. Jesus, you died for me. You died on the cross for me. You shed your blood for me. Lord, I come. Lord, I come. Lord, I come. Forgive me. Save me. Change my life. I take you, Jesus, as my Savior.
Yes,
I open up the door of my heart. Come into my heart. Come in to stay. Thank you, Lord.
Yes,
thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I am saved. I am forgiven. Because you have said, whosoever comes to me, I will in no wise cast away. I have received you, Christ. And I know you have received me in Jesus' name. Amen. Keep up that hand. I'm going to pray with you. Keep up that hand. I'm going to pray with you. You're coming to Christ. You have repented. You're taking him as your Savior. Keep up that hand. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for all my new brothers and sisters. Thank you for the sinners who have repented, for the backsliders who have returned home, for prodigal sons and daughters who have come back to the Father. They have come to you, Lord. I pray you forgive them in Jesus' name. All the sins they have committed, the ones they don't remember, according to your mercy, grace, and love, forgive them in Jesus' name. Count them as your children now. They have chosen life. Take condemnation away from them. They have chosen life. Take eternal death away from them. They have chosen life. Take the punishment for sin away from them in Jesus' name. Receive them. Save them. Forgive them. Change their life. Let your new life come to every one of them. Thank you, Lord, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Your time of miracle has come. I want you to say that my time of miracle has come.
So we pe akoko ise iyanu mi ti de.
Amen.
Amen.
You will raise up your hand if you need a miracle. You need healing. You need deliverance. You need a particular miracle in your life. Just raise up your hand. That place where you have the sickness or the infirmity, you will lay your hand in that place while you raise up the other hand. If you are blind, get ready. The Lord will touch your blind eyes and you will see. If you are dead, get ready. The mighty power of God will get into your joints, in your bone, into your spinal cord. You'll rise up and walk after the prayer.
To ba de je ko ya ro ni agbara Olorun yo fowo kan isan ese egungun ese ati egun opa eyin re wa dide duro wa
mo. Any infirmity, any problem, wherever it may be, just get ready. As we mention the name of Jesus, there's power in that name.
Arun karun to ba wa ninu aye re iwo sa agbara di sile ta ba ti daruko Jesu agbara nbe ninu oruko
na. And after the prayer,
leyin adura yen,
you will check up yourself.
Wa wa yara re wo.
See what the Lord has done.
Ko wa wo Tolorun.
Already you have made the choice. Jesus is your deliverer and your healer. Keep up your hand and close your eyes as we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, Jesus. We thank you tonight because you have told us to make the choice. We
have
chosen Christ.
We
have chosen life.
We
have chosen His power.
We
have chosen His miracle.
We
come to the side of the Lord. Manifest yourself on everyone right here now in Jesus' name. Lord, you have given us Christ as a deliverer, as a healer, as a great physician. I'm asking, Lord, you will touch everyone right now, their infirmity, their curse, their yoke, their sicknesses. Take it away in Jesus' name.
Oluwa, mo n gbadura pe ni bayi, e fowo kan awon eniyan yin gbogbo egun, gbogbo aisan, gbogbo re pata le o ko kuro ni oruko Jesu.
Now I command every swelling, whether in the neck, at the back, in the tummy, or it's in a private part, whatever the name of that swelling, I command that swelling, come out in Jesus' name.
Ni bayi, mo n pase fun gbogbo to ba wu. Boya ni orun boya ni eyin boya ninu boya ni abe ni gbogbo nkan to ba wu ko wa nibe e jade loruko Jesu.
And any kind of internal disease,
gbogbo arun to ba wa ninu lorun,
that tuberculosis, I command you,
iko fe mo pa
se, come out in Jesus name,
jade loruko Jesu.
That hernia, come out in Jesus name,
ipake yen jade loruko Jesu.
High blood pressure or diabetes, whatever it is, come out in Jesus' name.
Eje riru tabi suga to po ninu ara jade loruko Jesu.
The problem in the respiration, asthma, I command you, you have no right to remain there. Come out in Jesus' name.
Wahala to wa ninu bi eni yen se mi mo pase fun e jade loruko Jesu.
And I command that the cancer and the ulcer will vanish away in Jesus' name.
Mo pase fun esan jerajegun ati ogbe enu jade loruko Jesu.
The pile and the other problems within the body, I pray that the mighty hand of the Lord will touch you right now. Be healed in Jesus' name.
Arun jadi jadi tabi orisirisi esan to wa ninu ago ara mo gbadura pe ki owo Olorun ko ke ko.
Any sickness in the blood system, in the body, or in the bone, on the skin, you have no right to be there. Christ has come to get rid of you. I command all those sicknesses be healed in Jesus' name. And then all the people that have demonic oppression, that spirit of insanity and madness, I command that demon, that evil spirit, you have no right to be there when I mention the name of Jesus. Come out in Jesus' name.
Mo pase mo si fi ase fun eyin gbogbo eyin emi esu pe e leto lati wa nbe yen. Mo pase e jade loruko Jesu.
All those evil personalities visiting the family, visiting that woman or that man, or moving about in the body of the object, I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo agbara okun awon eni okun ti won lo be ni ewo tabi ti won rin kaakiri ninu agbara, mo pase fun e jade loruko Jesu.
Every yoke, every curse in your life, by the authority the Lord has given me, I cancel that sin. I break that yoke. Be free, be delivered in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo ajaga gbogbo ide to wa ninu aye re nipa ifami ororo ye ati ase ti Oluwa fi fun mi, mo pase pe ki o dominira loruko Jesu.
For families who are barren,
fun awon ebi to yaga,
I'm asking for children.
Ti won bere fun omo,
I'm asking, oh Lord, you give them children.
Mo bere Oluwa fun won ni omo,
grant them their miracle babies in Jesus' name.
E fi omo iyanu jinki won loruko Jesu.
For those who are blind,
fun awon to foju,
I pray that the mighty hand of God,
mo gbadura pe owo agbara
Olorun, the healing hand of God,
owo iwosan
Olorun, the creative hand of God,
owo iseda Olorun,
those blind eyes now.
Yo, for what
those blind
for
eyes, I command you, begin to see in Jesus' name. Those who are deaf and dumb, I pray the Lord will touch your eardrums, will touch your vocal cords, that miracle of hearing, that miracle of speaking distinctly and clearly will happen right now in Jesus' name.
Just
one lame, paralyzed, having stroke,
or one
leg shorter than the other,
or
they don't have ability to rise up on their own and walk, oh Lord, I pray that your healing virtue will pass through their bodies right now. The weakness in their joints, in their bones, that weakness
Get out in Jesus' name. Strengthen their joints. Strengthen their spinal cord. Strengthen their whole body. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name.
The
Lord bring everyone before you. Anywhere there is sickness. Anywhere there is infirmity. Anywhere there is oppression. Anywhere there is attack. Anywhere there is affliction. I pray the hand of the Lord will touch you right now. Be healed. Be healed. Be delivered. Be set free. Let your miracle come upon you right now. Break every yoke, dear Lord. Set all your people free. Thank you, Lord, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.